Good morning, guys. It is Jonathan with One Big Impact. I want to talk really quick about why you're not losing weight and just in general, but obviously this can be for Atkins, this can be for macros, this can be pretty much for anything. I think one of the most under understood aspects of weight loss is the specificity. So if you are, you know, worried about making sure you're in a caloric deficit and finding out exactly what works for you as far as like, say your maintenance calories are 1500 and you know you got to get down to, or let's say your maintenance calories are like 1800 and you know you got to get down to like 1300 to start losing weight. Maybe you put yourself in a caloric deficit, 300 through exercise and 200 through food, and that works for you. And you go a few weeks and you find out, first of all, that you're not losing weight anymore. Initially, you dropped a few pounds and it worked out great, but then you get to a point to where it no longer works for you. So a few things could happen at that point. You could be changing things. So meaning a lot of people will say, I don't have certain foods and stuff like that, so I just switch out, you know, one day I didn't have steak, so I switched it out for chicken, or vice versa, or I had this hamburger meat, but I switched it out for this hamburger meat. Hamburger meat's the same, right? Not necessarily and completely not at all. So the most important thing that you have to remember is if you are taking yourself into a deficit through exercise and calories, that is a very specific thing. So if you tell me you are consuming 1400 calories and you are burning 300 calories, then that 1100 mark or whatever it is needs to be consistent. It needs to be every single day, each and every single day. There's no fluctuations, there's no ability. And if you are putting yourself into a 3,500 caloric deficit each week of calories, then say 1 week that you don't make that target and you're switching out foods and stuff like that, and you end up, maybe you got 2,500 calories or something like that. In the big scheme of things, then you'll probably drop something, maybe, half a pound, quarter pound, 3/4 of a pound or something like that. But if you really want to be consistent with your weight loss results, you have to be consistent with your food and make sure that you are consuming the same things each and every single day and you are burning the exact same calories or more each and every single day. Because if you don't, you have to understand that one of the biggest factors is your body's stubborn and it's really good at holding on to weight. It's a survival tactic. It's not doing it because it hates you. It's doing it because it's really important that it survives through whatever stimulus or whatever things that you're going through in life. It doesn't understand that you're not in a cave or in the Sahara, you know, chasing lions or something. Our bodies are really good at holding on weight, and it's really positive. Our bodies don't give a crap if we're lean. The other thing is that you have to understand that you're not always going to be dropping weight. You could be at a point to where you're dropping inches or where you're dropping body fat or whatever it is. I think what people aren't realizing is, you know, maybe you didn't drop a pound this week, but maybe you dropped 5 inches. Now, in the same sense, if you're saying I am always dropping inches and I'm not dropping weight, something's wrong. You're basically, that's a cop out. You're full of shit and you're not really getting anywhere. If you keep saying I'm dropping weight, I'm dropping inches, that's not true, because eventually you will drop weight. If you're not, you're doing something wrong, whether you're eating one meal out or something like that. It's very easy to put yourself into a caloric surplus without even basically trying. At the end of the day, you got to make sure you're eating regularly. And people say OMAD works great and stuff like that, and maybe it does for some people, and that's awesome. But at the big scheme of things, if you eat one meal a day, a lot of people get overweight like that because your body says, hey, I'm only eating one meal a day. I'm just going to hold on to everything. Now, it works great for some people because they can only consume so many calories at a time. Also, understanding that there is an element of hunger involved with weight loss. Okay, so this is why Atkins and keto and high-fat diets, high-protein diets work so well. It's not that you're not in a caloric deficit just the same. It's when you are low carb and you're eating high-fat and high-protein diets or way of eating keep your satiation better. So if you are eating protein, it keeps you fuller longer. It's harder for your body to digest. It takes longer and stuff like that. And then when you eat carbs and sugar, it's like fire, especially sweets. If you eat a pack of donuts or something like that, 20 minutes later, you're like, oh my gosh, I'm hungry again, because it's very fast to metabolize. Like it goes right into your bloodstream. That's why a lot of like power lifters and lifters and stuff like that will eat those type of things before or after they work out, because it just gets sucked into the muscles so fast. And if you're not using it in the muscles, it's just getting dumped into the storage as fat. So, understanding that although those things combat hunger, fats and proteins and stuff like that, you technically should still be getting hungry every once in a while. And it's so funny because I think one of the hardest things to understand is that when you are dropping weight, if you're 200 pounds, 300 pounds, 400 pounds, or anything like that, you are twice the size, maybe three times or more the size of a normal human being. Which means you're going to have to get rid of the food that the other bitch is eating, if that makes sense. Like, whatever she's eating is important that she's not eating it. If you're eating for the size of two or three humans, well, knock some of that off. And technically speaking, if you've stretched your stomach out this big and it's only supposed to be this big, you got to bring it back down to size. So you're going to have to deal with some hunger left and, here and there. And there's nothing wrong with naturally becoming more in tune to actually getting to the point to where you're hungry before you eat. 90% of us never even got there. It's a very weird feeling and people feel uncomfortable when they're hungry. But in the big scheme of things, that's probably 90% of our problem. We're eating when we're not even hungry. We're eating because we want to socialize. We're eating because it's the love of food, or it's sweets, or we're bored, or it's just a bad habit, or you're eating sweets, or you're eating food that raises your blood sugar and then it dips, and then you go to get it back again and you get high off it. And a lot of the times, people really don't know or remember what it's like to be hungry. So I think that's a very, very big factor and a very scary thing for a lot of people. And in all reality, it's a beautiful thing because this is your body's natural way of saying, hey, it's time to eat. And usually, right around when you get hungry, it's time to eat your meal. You can eat every 2, 3 hours when you're awake, and you can lose weight just fine. If you are the type of person that says, I'm starving, first of all, you're not freaking starving. You're clearly eating calories, and you're not starving if you're 200, 300 pounds overweight or anything like that. But if that's the case, eat smaller meals more often. Just snack, meaning if you have 5 meals, bust it into 10. Or five or six or seven or whatever, but make it into smaller meals so you snack all through the day. If you've ever noticed, people that are in really good shape tend to be always eating. They're not always eating like a whole pizza, but usually they're always eating something small, whether it's like a little package of nuts or some cheese or an apple or something like that. They're kind of always going along the process. Keeping your body full throughout the day is pretty damn easy, and you don't have to be stuffed. In order to be able to drop weight and stuff like that, you really never eat to where you're like sick. And I've done that on multiple occasions when I'm not trying to drop weight, and it's really not good for you. If you feel like you're gonna pass out after a meal, chances are you ate too damn much. I hope this information helped you. Be stronger than your excuses. Remember to spread love, not hate. Check us out on Facebook. Our group is called Healthy Living for Healthy Life. Have a beautiful day. Remember to spread love, not hate. I don't know if I said that. Team Boo, and have a good day. I'm like stuck on my words. I'm trying to get out of here.